Hello and welcome to this video lecture series on digital communication. We are discussing the information theory part, and in that we are discussing the turbo code. Turbo code is actually a special type of convolutional code only. So whenever we have convolutional code, it has a particular length. But if we want to increase the length of the convolutional code, we can do it with the help of turbo coding. So why we need to increase the length? We increase the length to make the signal more random. So whenever we increase the randomness of the signal, the encryption properties of the code would increase. So now my signal or my code is more secure. So now I hope now you understand why I need turbo code. Turbo code is a special type of convolutional code which is more secure, which is having more length than convolutional code, and thus it is having more randomness than convolutional code. So I wrote it is of more length, more randomness, more secure. And I also wrote its parallel concatenation of convolutional code. So now you must be wondering what is parallel concatenation. So there are three types of concatenation: series, parallel and hybrid. So first we'll see series. So this is my encoder, which is called the inner encoder. It is connected to an outer encoder also. So whenever I have two encoder, the length of the code would increase. So now this code is sent to the channel. Now the channel is connected to the inner decoder, and then it is connected to the outer decoder. So this is the serial connection. The outer code and the inner code are connected serially. After that, I have parallel connection. So now in parallel connection, two encoders are connected parallelly. So now after that, I can have hybrid connection as well. So now here you can see encoder 1 is connected to encoder 3 serially, but encoder 1 is connected to encoder 2 parallelly. So this is called my hybrid connection. So this is my series connection, this is my parallel connection, and this is my hybrid connection. In series connection, so if I remove this part, so this is my encoded signal. So the encoded signal will have just one output, V1. Here I have two output, V1, V2. Here also I have two output, V1, V2. So in turbo coding, what we are doing, we are taking the parallel concatenation. So we are taking this part to increase the length of the code. So with the help of this, I'll get V1 and V2, and with the help of this, the length of the code would increase, which increases the randomness in the code. So I have another term which is called interleaving. Interleaving is the rearrangement of the code. So we'll use these things, and now we'll see the encoder of the turbo code. So this is my message signal. I am taking a direct output. So this is V1. I am taking this output, which is connected with the help of feedback. Feedback is used to increase the randomness, and which is further used to increase the length of the code. So this is my interleaver. So this is my basic encoder. This is my interleaver. Interleaver is used to make the message code rearranged. And after that, it is going to this part, which is the same as this part. So the rearranged code would go here, and there I'll get the V3. So V1, V2 and V3 I am getting, which is used to increase the length. So we'll see how the length is increased. So let's understand this with the help of this basic diagram. So this is my empty. Empty is directly connected to give me V1. It is connected to encoder 1. So I am taking full this part as encoder 1. And so let's take, it's a basic form like this. This is my V2. And now again I'll take an interleaver pi. I'm denoting the interleaver with the help of pi. After that, this is encoder and this is V3. So let's understand this. Whenever I have 1 as the message, so I have to increase the length of this code. I have to encode this 1. I have to increase the length to increase the randomness to make my code more secure. So now when 1 is sent here, so I can encode as it as 1 plus D. So when 1 is sent V1, here I'll get 1 only. So now when 1 plus D, it is in the form of 1 plus D, it is sent here. So here also I'll get 1. But I am representing it as 1 and a long stream of zeros. So I can represent it like this. So whenever this 1 is shifted with the rearranged with the help of interleaver, so this 1 can go to the last 1 and in between I'll have zeros. So if I have n number of bits, it can now it can be represented as first bit is 1, which is 1, and the last bit, so nth bit is 1, so which means d raised to power n minus 1. So here I'll get d raised to power n minus 1 plus 1 upon 1 plus d. So here I hope you can see I'll get a lot of 1s. So whenever this is of the power n minus 1, this is of the power 1. So whenever it is divided, I'll get n minus 2 number of 1s. So I'll get a long stream of 1s. So this is how I can increase the length of the code with the help of this turbo coding. So now, so I have two types of turbo code. First is symmetric. Symmetric is when the constituent encoders are same. So these are two encoders. This is first encoder, this is second encoder. I took these two as same. So this is my symmetric case. In asymmetric, these two would be different. So now I hope you understood types of turbo codes. So now we'll move to a basic concept which is called puncturing. So whenever I have three outputs, but now I don't require three outputs. So whenever t is equal to 0, if I am taking V1 and V2 as output, and whenever t is equal to 1, I am taking V1 and V3 as output. So this time I just have two outputs. So I can generalize it. So whenever t is equal to 0, or I can say whenever t is even, I am taking the output as the combination of V1 and V2. And whenever the time is odd, I am taking these two outputs combined. So now my outputs are 2 now. So this is called puncturing. So I converted the three outputs in the form of two outputs. So this is called puncturing in the turbo code. So now why it is required? At this time the code rate, so rate is equal to 1/3 in this case, but in this case code rate would be 1/2. So now I hope you understood the basic concept of puncturing. So with the help of the basic concept of puncturing, I can change the code rate. So now I have multiple turbo code. So in multiple turbo code, what I'll do, I'll have the message signal I'll take the direct output, which is V1. After that, I'll pass it to encoder 1. I'll take the output, which is V2. After that, I'll pass it through interleaver 1. I'll pass it to encoder 2. I'll take the output V3. And after that, I'll pass it to interleaver 2. Pass it to encoder 3. I'll get V4. So here, my code rate is 1 by 4. So this is called my multiple turbo code. Here I took two interleaver. So here I'll get first rearrangement. So if my message signal is 1001, maybe first interleaver can convert it as 1010, and the second interleaver would give me. So this is my pi1 output. Pi2 output would be somewhat different than this. So it can give me this. So I hope now you understood. We have two interleavers which are giving me two rearranged form. So this is giving me first random sequence, which is rearranged of empty. This is giving me second random sequence, which is again the second rearrangement of empty. So after that, these are passed through encoder 1, 2, 3. If these encoders are same, we'll call it symmetric. If these encoders are of different kind, we'll call it asymmetric. I'll stop at this point for this video. I hope you like this video. If you like it, share it with your friends. Like this video and also push the subscribe button. Thank you.